30 seconds. There are many things that we do naturally in everyday life, whether it be holding the door open for someone or closing the door when you're in the bathroom, because I know a lot of people don't do that, or when you're helping someone with studying. We see these obstacles in our life and we see these situations and tasks, and it's just normal to us, and we forget to be thankful for many things. This reminds me of a quote that I once read. Silent gratitude isn't very much use to anyone, like Gertrude Stein. I am personally very accountable for this, as I forget to say thank you for a lot of things. When you see something done for yourself, whether it be for something as small as being lent a pencil, do you ever remember to thank that person? Or when you see something on television, or a celebrity doing a task that you think is incredible, do you ever realize in your life the things that other people do around you that you never feel grateful for? Today we're going to discuss an in-depth meaning of what this quote means, examples in everyday life of how we can go about this, and how we can put this into practice, and different examples that provide us with the most available tasks and how to be thankful in everyday life. Now what this quote means, what Gertrude Stein is really trying to address, is the amount of vulnerability we are being unable to express our thoughts. When we are thankful for something and we can't voice our feelings because we're afraid or we forget, other people may not feel the same way, and they may forget to be thankful for themselves. In everyday tasks, when you realize that you forgot to, per se, lend the pencil back that you had borrowed, do you ever remember to thank that person after you've done that? We forget to be grateful for many things, and in return, the person that we speak to or we address may feel less of themselves. This may lead to different examples of social differences, when we find ourselves being unable to voice our opinion. Because we are silently grateful for so many things, we forget to voice what we are actually most thankful for. This goes for anything in everyday life, and it goes for the smallest things. When you see something, a task that is so small, but simple, and you should be grateful for it, do you ever realize and take the time to really address the situation? Now, going on into a personal story of mine. I remember in times when I was in need, and for example, when I had my first sibling. Although it was such a great time for my parents, I wasn't that thankful. I was used to being an only child, and for that, I was a negative person. Although I was so small, I felt very resentful of my siblings, and with that led to negative aspects of my life. And I realized that even though it was such a hard task, that there were so many positive things about it. And now I am incredibly grateful for everything I've been given. This also goes for many people in society. Although we as students don't take into account the things that our educators do for us, they do so many things and aren't recognized for that. There are many professions in society today that are overlooked, and this goes for teachers. It goes for the smallest jobs, such as plumbers or engineers, and we forget to be thankful for everything that they do. In society, that leads to many people feeling negatively about themselves and their profession. And although they love what they do, when they aren't appreciated or recognized for that, it can lead to discouragement of themselves. Now, how we can go about this and put this into practice? As she said, silent gratitude is no use to anyone. So the next time you find yourself in a situation where you're being helped or where someone else is just there for you, remember to thank them. And remember that although it may seem so small, a simple gesture goes a long way. Now, back to my story with my siblings. That goes for everyday life and for all other situations, whether it be helping someone with the smallest tasks, When you find yourself in a situation such as that, you should remember that there are many things in life that are taken for granted for. And you should take every opportunity to address every situation that you're in and every people that you meet in that life.